Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Michael Turner.
My name is Michael Turner.
Parlor Sessions. And this first tune is entitled All the Way.
Yeah. Thank you.
Justin Bieber, but we featuring Michael Turner today. Okay, so y'all ready to get this thing cracking and rolling?
Come on,
dude. Yeah.
All right, all right. Here we go, y'all.
I love that.
here we go. Show and tell.
I ain't gonna do it this time. No way. I ain't marching for nobody else. I might march to my own self, go march right on to that beat.
Yeah.
Y'all red day? Anybody red day or red tie or whatever? Or is for all those other folks out there, are y'all ready? Y'all know who I'm talking to, the ones that got that thorn stuck up on the side. You know, I'm just like.
At Parlor Sessions, it's very intimate, so you are welcome to dance if you feel the need.
All right.
That's all right.
Can I dance too?
You are. Oh.
Thank you. Y'all, let's get it cracking. How do you say? Let's get it going. Here we go.
Hey, Camille, how you doing?
Oh, I'm so proud.
Always a pleasure to see you.
It is always a pleasure.
Yes.
How are you?
How are you? Great yourself.
I am fantastic. Now that I just finished listening to you and those amazing sounds.
Thank you.
That was rhapsody right there.
Thank you.
Notes of many colors. Thank you so much for sharing. Michael, tell me this. How did you even get started?
Well, I got started kind of late. A lot of people say, people think that I started when I was like 3 or a young kid, but actually I started when I was a sophomore in high school. So, and I'm originally from Chicago. So the school that I went to, I just remember my freshman class was 1,126 freshmen, so the school was so big. And I just remember that during my freshman year, they gave me all of these different, because it was a vocational school. So I was into welding at my first semester. I went to wood shop, I think my second, and I could think I went to welding. And what's that, what they have, the T square and all that, doing the architect,
okay.
Something like that. And so my mom said, well, you gotta pick something, because they just gonna give you anything. And I thought, and I said, well, you know, I know we had the aviation program that I thought I was gonna go into. So I thought I wanted to do that. And I said, no, I don't wanna do that. And I know I don't wanna get my hands oily and dirty, so I didn't wanna be a mechanic. So I said, I need to pray. And I sat there and prayed on the bench for like 1 minute, literally. And then it came to me. And my mom said, what do you wanna do? And I said, Mom, I wanna be in a band. And she said, what you wanna play? Now in my mind, I wanted to play the xylophone.
Okay, okay.
But out of my mouth came saxophone. Okay? This is the honest God truth. I'm not kidding. I'm not making this up. So we goes up to the band room, and it's about maybe 400 plus, maybe, because the band was that big out of high school bands, CBS, the largest school in the city of Chicago.
So this is your freshman year?
This is the beginning of the end of my freshman year, but I started actually in my sophomore year.
Okay.
So we walked around the band room. Michelangelo Taylor was the band director at the time. And he said, what do you want to play, son? So I walked around and I went to the percussion section last.
Don't tell me you remember what you played.
No, I didn't. No, I walked around the room and I walked around each section, and at the percussion section, I remember I went there last. But once I got back in front of everybody, he said, what you want to play, son? I said, in my mind, I want to play saxophone. You know, and he brings out this alto sax. And I'm thinking as he's bringing this, I don't think that thing over there could fit in that. So when he opens up the case, I look down, it's an alto sax. So he said, this is what you want to play, son? So to save face, because I didn't want all the kids laughing at me and saying, oh, he's a stupid or something, you know. I said, yeah, that's it.
For the music illiterate ones there, how many saxophones are there?
It's about, I want to say, 7, 8?
Okay.
You have piccolo sax, I'm counting on my hands now. Soprano sax, alto sax, and it's a C melody. That's in between the alto and the tenor. So it's a C melody. Then you have the tenor sax. That's 5. And then you have the baritone sax. That's 6. And then you have a bass sax. So it's 7.
Okay. And which one are we playing today?
Is the alto.
Oh, so you stuck with?
Well, this is the one that I just channeled my energy mostly in. I said, you know, I might as well gonna put a lot of these eggs in this basket over here. You know, because a lot of people say, you shouldn't put all your eggs in one basket, but I wanted to make somebody into a believer.
Okay.
That you can do anything you put your mind to and your heart into, no matter what it is. If you believe in it, and most of all, believe in yourself, you can do anything.
I love it when you said, in my mind, I wanted to play the
xylophone.
But
out of my mouth was saxophone. Yes, so that means that it was divine. That means that it was a purpose for me to do this that I didn't know that it was my purpose to do this, because I'm living this. This is what I do. So it was God's purpose for me to do this. So actually, well, since I started 1987,
okay.
and And so I went on to graduate. I went to Grammy State, and I'm just paraphrasing. Then I toured with Otis Clay for about 4 years. So then I went into the Marines. I was in the Marine Corps band. And then I came home for a while. I, you know, started doing my own thing. And then I said, I got to get back on track here. So obviously I was out playing back in Chicago, and some of my old friends, like, you disappeared. So here comes a couple of my friends saying, okay, well, the saxophone is for the Ohio Players. They called him Darkwing. Mm-hmm. He passed, and so they needed another saxophonist. So they had chosen out of about six other guys. They said, let's give Michael a shot. And they gave me a shot, and I held it down for like 15 years. You know, so last month was my last month with them. So, and I learned, it was a great experience. So now it's time to, you know, as they say, you know, with the umbilical cord, you guys have to be seven.
15 years with the Ohio Players.
Yes.
Travel.
Yes.
Everywhere.
Mostly everywhere. A lot of places.
Everywhere.
Yeah, I got a chance to see.
They're known all over the world.
Yes, and actually they'll be here August the 21st.
Are you playing with them?
No, not with them anymore.
You said that this month was your last
month? Last month.
Last month was your last month?
Yes,
that was June?
Well, yes, that was June.
June 2022.
Yes.
Was your last month in Ohio Players.
Yeah.
So what is up and coming? Because when I talked to you, I heard this buzzword, and I was like, I can't wait to hear more. Mm-hmm. You said, I'm in the studio.
Yes, yes.
So what are we doing now?
So now we're creating originals, and we are going to make a statement before I leave this world, because everybody needs to know who I am.
Exactly.
You want
to leave it all on the, well, back in the day they had the 45s. So now what we doing? They had the vinyl. So what we doing now? Streaming?
And you know it. You know all that. And you know, and that's why we're here today. So I can connect with all you beautiful people. So the young people can be inspired more. Even the people that's of our age and older. So.
I like what you just said. So if you would look into the camera and inspire a young person for me that feel like they had a music career and they may somewhere in between got off track. Mm-hmm. I heard you say for a minute there I had to get back on track.
Exactly.
So what would you say to that person?
I would say this. You know, through the power of God, you can do anything. And just know that if you believe in yourself, no matter what that is, if you channel your energy into your gift, you can supersede the talent. Talent you can teach. A gift is given from God. So when God gives you a gift, you know, don't let it go. And follow your dreams and your passions. And you always will make it. Just believe in yourself and put in first. No matter what that dream or that passion is, just don't stop. Always keep on going to the top. That's a motto. Never stop going to the top. And remember this, everybody is somebody.
While you're going up, everybody is somebody. Always strive for the top.
Yes.
I love it too because, yes. You know, my some people just don't believe in God.
Well, for those unbelievers, then, you know, we just pray for them too. But it's all good.
I'm sticking to the plan.
Yeah, exactly. So, you know, whatever you believe, most of all, believe in yourself. That's the most thing, important thing. If you don't believe in yourself, that's like, okay. So if I believe in myself, I can take this thing right here, and I can make it do what it do. And it's making it do what it do for me. It's making a living for me and making a way. And I'm getting a chance to share my gift and my passion with the world. So, you know.
That's amazing. Thank you so much for joining us tonight with the production of Sugar Bowl for our parlor session here at Envision Hair Salon, taking the time out of your busy, busy schedule, and we are wishing many blessings and favor upon your life. So
keep moving forward,
and we thank you.
Thank you for this platform, and everybody envisions once again, Camila. She is the bomb. Thank you. Thank you.
It was amazing. He hit all the notes. He was vibing with the audience, and it was just great. You could tell that he was very passionate about his craft, and you could hear his talent play as he was playing the sax.
And I've always liked the saxophone and jazz music, but I've never gotten to hear it live. So this was a really great experience. Just all together, and then I could tell the ad-lib, and there's a lot of practice that I could hear when he was doing it, and then he was able to go and just improvise and just go with the flow and be in the tune. It was really great.
Come on down to Parlor Sessions.
Great.